You're here in search of something. It's part of your destiny. You want to understand the world around you better. Your journey has led you here, and you're amongst those seeking the same things. Your quest for the truth has taken you this far. Welcome to the world of decoding reality.
Alexa, did the government release the coronavirus?
According to Event 201, the government planned this event, created the virus, and had a simulation of how the countries would react. This simulation occurred October 18, 2019. The government released the virus among the population and has lost control of the outbreak.
And hello everyone, welcome once again. My name is Logan and this is Decode Your Reality. Today I'm doing a video on what you just heard, which it was the first time I heard it. I just found it today. Man, this is Alexa and the coronavirus decoded. Folks, I think it's just becoming very crystal clear with these, movies and TV shows that are coming out way before it ever happens that should tell you loud and clear what's going on in our world. I mean, we're talking about artificial intelligence and it, of course, speaking what it only knows. I mean, it didn't sound doctored up to me. What do you feel is the truth? Did it sound legit? Certainly sounded legit to me, folks. It didn't blow me away because I'm not surprised anymore. It just was another nail in the coffin. So let's roll this out and show you what I found. The date that Alexa gives for the actual simulation is the 18th of October. And folks, you gotta start looking at the conversions from the Gregorian calendar into the Hebrew calendar because, unfortunately, I have to pinpoint a certain background of people. That's just the way it is. To give us deeper clues and meanings. It all keeps coming to the same source and origins, folks. Nonetheless, the date in question, 18 October, on the Hebrew calendar is the 19th of Tishrei, or Tishrei. I'm not sure if I said that right. If I said it wrong, my apologies. But the big standout is the 19, as in COVID-19. Oh, that's just one. I'm going to show you another one to support what I'm saying. This is really where it's at. I mean, this is the calendar. October 2019 is the date of the simulation. Here's the conversion. And here it is, here's the actual calendar, and here's the date right here. And there's a holiday that they celebrated for 7 days straight. It's this one right here. So here's the 19th. And when you click on that, it's one of three biblically mandated festivals on which they were commanded to make a pilgrimage to the temple in Jerusalem. Notice the word pilgrimage. That's the big standout. They were commanded to make a pilgrimage. What does that mean? Well, I went to Google and I typed in the word pilgrimage and look at the picture that it shows for the Wikipedia. I mean, I didn't pick the Mecca. It's just standard right there. And look at the definition, folks. You tell me if this doesn't describe introducing a simulation into the world to see what happens. A pilgrimage is a journey, often into an unknown or foreign place, where a person goes in search of new or expanded meaning about the self, others, nature, or a higher good through the experience. Does that not describe what they would be doing by going ahead and creating a simulation of the COVID-19 before it happens? As a command for the temple in Jerusalem? Kind of sounds like it to me. Remember, folks, you got to use your common sense. Most people don't have that. You know, not you, but, you know, most people don't have common sense. This is not stretching things, folks. We are putting pieces of a puzzle together. That's what you have to do. It's not going to be rolled out to you. It's not going to be pretty sometimes. You're going to piss people off when you start to unveil the truth. But that's what it takes to understand what's running this world so we can remove the virus. There's a virus in this matrix, folks. It needs to be removed. Here's the date in question. October 18th, they run the simulation on this date. According to Alexa, look at this. It's 291st day of the year, but there's 74 days remaining till the end of the year. That's the big standout, which is why I have it circled. The element tungsten. Maybe you've never seen this before, but when you connect days to elements of the periodic table, you start to get clues that tell you things on how they work. And 74 is linked to the element tungsten. It illuminates. It's for light bulbs. Illumination. Look at the abbreviation for this element. The letter W. And what was the first letter of the city that the coronavirus supposedly came out of? The latitude, longitude of Wuhan is 144, as in 144,000. They think they're the chosen ones. The letter W is the 23rd letter in the English alphabet. The word crown in numerology equals the number 23. Event 201 is what Alexa said it was called. 201 equals the number 55. 55 is massive because it's the 10th Fibonacci number. If you don't know what Fibonacci is, go press pause and Google that. Very important. It follows the patterns in nature. I'm showing this because the 10th letter in the Hebrew and Aramaic alphabet is the Yod. This is the Yod, as in the Yod-Heh-Vah-Heh, as in the Yahweh, as in the New Age name Jehovah. Same thing. The 10th letter in the English alphabet is the letter J. That's why they flipped it into Jehovah. Same energy, folks. Look at this. The actual chronological order of the coronavirus. This is what I got off of Wikipedia. 17 November is when the first confirmed case of this virus took place, and it was a 55-year-old man. You know, folks, you look at this stuff. I mean, what are the odds of these numbers linking up like that? And I'm just going to say it again. I've said it. I keep saying it. Man is being used to carry out the divine's purpose. Being used. Man's not doing this alone. Not possible. What about the number 19 on the date 17 November? Remember, I'm talking about the first recorded confirmed case of the coronavirus. 55-year-old man, matching that of 201. Well, that on the calendar, on the Hebrew calendar, is another 19. So the two big dates that I'm showing you are linked to why they named it Corona 19. Keep in mind, the 19th card on the tarot is the Sun card. The Son of God. The YHVH is a sun deity, folks. 19. 19, the word battery equals 19 in numerology. What about the number 201? What does that have anything to do with anything? Well, it's the planet Mercury, folks. Mercury is the planet of communication. Quicksilver. He's the one responsible to tell all the other gods what's going on, to communicate with the planet. Well, 201, Mercury's weight. One of his weights is 201. Notice the word Mercury equals 23, just like the word crown. Mercury works for the crown. And remember, there's as above, so below. You have the divine crown and then the mankind crown. I'm going to leave it with this one. Oh, no, I have one more slide after this, folks. Event 201 again is 55. And then when we bring pi into this, the digits of pi, the never-ending, the 3.1415, the never-ending, the infinite amount of numbers inside of the zero, the pi. Look at where 201 stands at, folks. 244. 201 appears at the 244th decimal digit of pi. And that's linked to the element plutonium. Plutonium, Pluto. Pluto is Hades, the god of the underworld, the destroyer. Pluto is Shiva. And I'm showing that because here's my last slide, folks. This is going to be really interesting this year, folks, because the last time we had a revolution was around the year 1774, 75, and then the Declaration of Independence was written in 1776. Pluto is in Capricorn. Well, Pluto's in Capricorn right now again. History repeats itself. Pluto is in Capricorn. We're in the year 2020. You subtract 1776 and you're going to get the number 244. It's death and regeneration to the Constitution, folks. That's exactly what's going to happen. And this coronavirus is going to usher it in. That's why they want to keep you home. Not debating whether or not it's real or not. That's besides the point. The agenda behind it is to control man. And I really hope people start opening their eyes and understanding that's exactly what it's all about. There's so many different layers. There's, you know, 5G and there's all these other things, but those are just layers. Corona is there to deceive you. It's there to enslave you. It's there to bring down the Declaration of Independence, to bring in the New World Order. That's what plutonium's all about. Destruction. Shiva, the god of destroy, right here. That's plutonium. That's why CERN has one of these in their courtyard at their location in Geneva. So you got to start opening up your eyes, folks. I mean, this was Alexa, artificial intelligence, giving the answers, and I just broke it down for you. What is it you saw during this presentation? I mean, look at these outcomes and these numbers, these 19s on these dates. And the W has a massive, massive piece in all this. I mean, this is clear right here, folks. It's clear. So that's all I got for today, folks. My name is Logan. This is Decode Your Reality. Thank you so very much for watching.